Monsieur Collard.
Mademoiselle Collard, my name is Plantard. I need to talk to you about your story, your Pierre Carchon story.
How did you know about that?
There are people out there, madame, who will be very upset by this story.
Oh, really? Well, it's their lucky day. It's been spiked.
Yes, I know. We must meet.
We must?
I have information relating to your costume killer stories. Tomorrow morning, 8 a.m., Café de la Chandelle Verte, Rue Alain Court. I shall be wearing a grey overcoat. You must talk to no one about this.
You can't tell me what to...
Tomorrow at 8. I'll be waiting.
People complain about newspaper articles all the time, but not usually before they're printed. I was beginning to feel scared. This guy, Plantard, could I trust him? Should I meet him or forget the whole business? I didn't have an answer.
I'd only been in Paris for a week, but already I'd fallen in love with the city. My latest discovery was a little cafe, La Chandelle Verte. I was pretty sure the waitress was taking a shine to me. That old Stobart charm, I guess. Little did I know, my reverie was about to be so rudely interrupted. As I picked myself up, I was really angry. One minute, I'm on vacation. The next minute, some clown's blown me up. I knew right away what I was gonna do. I was gonna find that clown and bring him to justice. Because justice matters. Justice is up there with liberty. And equality. And, fraternity. After all, that's why I'd studied law, wasn't it? Well, that and the money, of course.
I examined the jagged glass remaining in the window. It was broken, all right. The table had been overturned by the explosion. I considered straightening the table, but I figured it best not to disturb the evidence. Wrapped around the lamppost was a newspaper. The leading article referred to the visit of a Nobel Prize winner from some unpronounceable Eastern European state.
The column was devoted exclusively to rumor, gossip, and sensationalism. The big story was about the brutal murder of a French media magnate, shot down in cold blood. The guy oozed confidence, like a regular French statesman. I noticed the writing at the foot of the page. It read, Salah ed-Din, 1345. The waitress was clearly suffering from shock.
Oh, my head. Never again. How much vodka did I drink? Oh, no, don't tell me. What is your name, Sherry?
George Stobart, ma'am. You look like you could use a little help.
I could use a little drink. I feel sick, dizzy, and bruised. I don't even remember the party.
Just relax and take it easy. You've been knocked out.
You don't say. What happened?
There's been an explosion. You should try not to move.
Are you a doctor?
No, but I used to play hospitals when I was a kid. Can you remember anything at all?
No. I need a drink. Pour me a brandy.
You could be in shock. No alcohol.
What about the old man? Is he dead?
I don't know. I haven't looked at him yet. Do you remember what happened when the clown entered?
I remember that horrible tune he played all right. It was like a funeral dirge.
I'd never liked accordion music either. Did the clown speak to the old man?
No, he just laughed at him. Then he grabbed the old man's briefcase and ran out of the door.
Did the old man try to stop the clown?
Oh,
He didn't have a chance. The clown dropped his accordion and ran out of the door. That's it. That's all I can remember.
Did you know the old man?
No, monsieur. I never saw him before.
How did the old man behave?
Well, agitated. He kept looking about him, at the door, at his watch.
As if he was waiting for someone?
Yes, I suppose so. He was worried about something, that's for sure. If you ask me, he was having an affair. He had that look about him, like a guilty husband.
Did you see what the old man had in his briefcase?
No, he didn't open it.
What did the old man do when the clown snatched his briefcase?
Nothing. He just sat there like he was frozen.
Did this newspaper belong to the old gentleman?
I don't know.
Someone has scribbled a note on it. It reads, Salah ed-Din, 1345. Does that mean anything to you?
No, monsieur, nothing.
Stay here, mademoiselle. I'm going to look around for evidence. A mysteriously undamaged bottle of spirit stood on the bar. I needed a stiff drink, but I hated the taste of brandy. It was the body of the old man. It was hard to believe I'd seen him alive only minutes before. The sight of the dead guy's staring eyes turned my knees to jelly. I tried not to meet his stare as I searched the dead man's pockets. No wallet, no papers, no credit cards. The guy's past was a blank page. I'd hoped the fact that the mirror was already broken meant I'd escaped the bad luck. The mirror had smashed into 1,000 pieces. Bad luck for someone. Poor guy. He was pretty mashed up.
Please! Hold it! Right there!
Whoa! Don't shoot! I'm innocent! I'm an American!
Can't make up your mind, huh?
I demand to see the American consul!
Drop your weapons and get down on the ground!
Put that thing away, Sergeant Moo. I apologize, monsieur, but I cannot permit you to leave.
Am I under arrest?
Ah, no. I would simply like to ask you some questions. En avant, to the café, marche! What a mess. This bombing is an outrage, is it not?
Stop that, monsieur!
Has it occurred to you that he may be dead, Moo?
Oui, monsieur. But I prefer to look on the bright side. Besides, I recall a case where the killer escaped by feigning death. However, in this case, the man is quite dead.
Examine the girl and take her statement, if you can. Et maintenant, to business. Your name, please?
George Stobart. I'm from California.
And what brings you to Paris, Monsieur Stobart?
Travel. I'm touring Europe.
You chose well. The city is most beautiful at this time of year, no?
Yeah, I guess so, apart from the bomb blasts.
Were you in the vicinity of the cafe at the time of the explosion?
Yeah, I was sitting out on the sidewalk. I was lucky I wasn't killed. The inspector passed over my remark with no reaction.
Did you see the deceased enter the cafe?
Yes, I did.
Was he alone?
Yeah.
And did he say anything to you?
No. He was more interested in the waitress.
Did you see anyone else in the cafe?
Yeah, there was a guy dressed as a clown. He was carrying an accordion.
An accordion? Bon, the picture is forming in my mind, and it is not a pretty one. Is the girl all right, Moo?
She'll live. She confirms the American statement. A clown with an accordion, no doubt an elaborate and eccentric disguise.
Very well. Eh bien, I have heard enough.
What do you mean?
I am satisfied that you know nothing. You may leave. I hope this little incident does not spoil the rest of your vacation.
What about my personal safety? Can't you at least give me some advice?
What can I say? Stay alert and look out for suspicious characters.
And don't cross the road until the little man shows green.
Great advice.
I honestly believe you are in no danger, monsieur. Should you remember anything of importance, please contact me. My card.
Thanks.
That is all. You may go.
There's not much to go on, monsieur.
On the surface, no. But what lurks inside the subconscious? If the door can only be opened.
Are you serious, monsieur? I thought your interest in psychic detection was purely academic.
The girl presented a confident but sullen mask to the world, an expression more suited to the face of a delinquent youth.
Excuse me, mademoiselle?
Hi. My name's George Stobart.
Oh, an American by the sound of it.
Yep, that's right. On vacation in Paris. Some vacation, huh?
You were here when the bomb went off?
Sure was. Sat right out in front of the cafe.
Did you notice a middle-aged man, maybe 60, with a hat and overcoat?
I couldn't believe it. She hadn't even asked how I was feeling. Yeah, he went inside just before the bomb exploded. You weren't related to him, were you?
Oh, no, nothing like that. I'm Nicole Collard, from La Liberté.
What is that, some kind of nightclub?
Oh, no, it's a newspaper.
You're a reporter?
I'm a freelance photojournalist.
Say, you could interview me about the bombing. An eyewitness account, minutes after the outrage that shook the whole of Paris. You know, real-life drama, human interest, that kind of stuff.
I'll just stick to the facts, thank you. Did you see who planted the bomb?
I know it sounds crazy, but he was dressed like a clown.
A clown? It's him again.
Who was the guy you were supposed to meet?
His name was Plantard. I didn't know him, but he called me last night. He said he had a story which would interest me. He asked me to meet him at the cafe. I guess I'll never know what he wanted to tell me.
Well, not unless you have Rosso's gift for psychic interrogation. How did Plantard get your name?
Through the newspaper, La Liberté. I'd written an article linking two unsolved murders, one in Italy, the other in Japan. The cases were remarkably similar. A wealthy victim, no apparent motive, and a costume killer. Plantard said he could supply me with more information. Somehow the clown must have known about our appointment.
Do you know a police officer called Rosso?
Rosso? Our paths have a knack of crossing. If I didn't know better, I'd say it was deliberate. Have you seen Rosso? Is he here?
He's inside, attempting to question a witness with his psychic powers.
That guy is weird.
Yeah. Look, the inspector gave me his card.
Oh, I didn't know his first name was Augustin. It suits him, I must say.
I found this newspaper outside the cafe.
That is not a newspaper, it's a gossip rag.
It may have belonged to Plantard.
So? He had a taste for sensationalist smut with right-wing bias. That doesn't tell us much.
There's something written in it. Salah ed-Din, 1345.
It sounds like a betting tip. The name of the horse and the time of the race. What do you think?
I don't think it is. That's too obvious. I wouldn't mind betting. This is a coded message.
It's a romantic notion, but I don't think so.
Have you met the clown before?
It's a long story.
I have plenty of time.
I don't.
Why won't you tell me about the clown?
Why do you want to get involved?
Because he almost killed me. Isn't that reason enough?
I guess so. Listen, I'll give you my phone number. You help me with my story and I'll let you in on what I know. And let's get one thing straight right now. This is strictly business.
Okay, it's a deal.
I have to go develop these pictures. I'll be on soon with you.
Fine. I'll see you soon.